Hi guys, my name is Vivek and today I'll be explaining you the data warehousing concept in a simplified manner. Before we go ahead, let's understand what do we mean by a data warehouse. So a data warehouse is a system that is used for reporting and data analysis. And from this data analysis, we derive some logical conclusions that help us in improving our businesses. So we'll be explaining the entire concept with the help of a simple example today. Mark, who is a CEO of an e-commerce website, he is willing to increase his profits by streamlining the process. So if you see, this is the basic model of seller point. Seller points has three components: customer, products and courier services. So these customers can buy these products and these products are shipped with these courier services. So let's take an example. Vivek can buy a shoe from bootmakers and that will be shipped by, say, Speedfast. So what Mark is doing is he is analyzing the data for last 1 month to identify which products or which customer has made money for him and what are the reason why he has incurred loss. So based on that data analysis, he'll come up with some logical conclusions to improve his business line. Let's analyze the data. So as I just mentioned, we have three entities: customers, products and couriers. And these are the details of the items that have been sold, say, over the last 1 month. So if you see, we have certain components that have been highlighted in red. So these are the items that have been returned. An item that has been returned has made no profit for the company. Rather, it has incurred losses. And the reason being, an item that was returned means it was shipped and then it was sent back. So that means it didn't make any profit for the company. So what are the reasons why these items were returned? For the first two items, the reason is the customer said that he didn't like the product. Vivek is the customer who bought a shirt and jeans and he said that he didn't like the product. Also, to note that the delivery status for this particular jeans was delayed. The other two items were, the reason for return was these items were damaged and these items were shipped by Batman couriers. So that means two items that were delivered by Batman couriers were damaged. Also, if you see, two items that were delivered by local couriers were delayed. So based on this, we can come up with some logical conclusions like few items were delivered late, few products were not sold at all, Vivek returned two of his three items, and Batman couriers, they delivered two broken items out of three. Obviously, Mark can come up with logical conclusions from the data we just saw. He can remove the Batman courier services. He can remove the unsold product line with new similar products. He should warn local couriers to expedite their delivery process. He should remove cash on delivery for Vivek as he is returning majority of his items. And he should give an additional discount to Neeraj on his next purchase as his previous purchase experience was not smooth. This will save him the name of the company because Neeraj will not give him a bad review in case if he gives an additional discount. So if the entire concept, if we want to understand this in terms of data warehousing, it's very simple. The three entities, customer, courier service and products, are dimensions. And the transaction table that we saw is a fact table. So the fact table has keys of all the dimensions and some additional columns which we call measures. So if you see a fact table, as I just mentioned, it has the primary key of all the associated dimensions and measures. So measures are used to evaluate the profits and loss gain. For example, here using the measures, I can calculate that which product made me how much money and things like that. Dimensions are the true driving tables as they provide descriptive information for all the measurements recorded in the fact. A vital thing to understand here is that dimensions in a data warehouse, dimensions have all to be loaded first. Always dimensions will be loaded first because you cannot sell a product that doesn't exist. Also, if you see, dimensions are relatively small in number because a product or customer can buy multiple items. That means Vivek, as a person, he can buy 10 items and that will make 10 entries in your fact table, but still he's a single customer. So in a data warehouse, usually 80% of the data is being consumed by fact tables. As I've already explained, the objective of data warehouse is to leverage the data for precise and effective decision making. Also, the data in warehouse is persistent. If I try to explain the data flow of data for reporting, first of all, the data enters the OLTP system. From there, it goes to the integration layer between OLTP system and data warehouse, which is ODS, operational data store. From the data warehouse, the data can go to data mart, on which the reporting can be done. So we still have some open questions like, what is an OLTP system, what is ODS, what is data mart, and why the reporting is not done on OLTP or ODS and instead it is done on data mart and data warehouse. What kind of reporting tools are being used? All these answers I'll give in my next session. In case if you have any more questions, you can reach out to us on www.internshipsfromhome.com and we'll be happy to help you. Thank you.